Hi, I'm Cassie, and I would like to begin by sending blessings to everyone on the planet. This video is about being true to you. Honor your entire being and honor your life force. Inquire and put forth the effort to know the contents of your heart and higher purpose for spiritual growth, and really give to others what feels joyful and aligned for your person. Do not bargain yourself away or sacrifice your truth, however, and do not avoid tasks that build discipline of the personal character. Ask your multi-dimensional selves what they need to feel balanced and peaceful as you pay attention to your energetic and physical well-being. Generating love and kindness to ourselves as a loving but firm self-parent is a part of spiritual maturity. It is very important to give generously to the inner child with acknowledgement and loving appreciation of witnessing the inner child's experiences. We can follow relationship mastery guidelines, which are a service to others method based in the law of one and cultivating God's sovereign free behavior while reaping the mutual energetic benefits of experiencing more spiritual connection and increased love and appreciation returning back from others to you. And so, without attachment or expectation, this happens naturally when you follow some basic guidelines. Improving your compassionate communication with others, improving your relating skills personally and in group dynamics is a skill set that will go a long way to serve your mission. Remember to be true to you, which is the spiritual ascension expanding consciousness process of which we learn how to become authentically and divinely human, radiating the virtues and spirits of Christ. In order to reconnect with life and thus have value for human life, one must experience feeling empathy and compassion for self and others. And this is the true core essence of every human being's highest potential. Without the experience of feeling emotion, a human being becomes disconnected and unable to feel or experience anything. Most humans are completely emotionally and energetically shut down from spiritual sickness, experienced through incredible trauma. And without access to emotional feeling, one cannot heal themselves or evolve through spiritual consciousness to find their true and authentic self. Challenges help us to experience things we may have defined for ourselves from a confused and delusional state of what we think we want out of our life experiences. And this delusion or ego confusion creates a spiritual misalignment, and we are often then corrected in order to get back into alignment with spiritual source again. And also, many times the delusion present is based upon choices we made in the past and is from a complete deception of what we actually thought was that life circumstance. And that means that we have built our life experience and our life choices have been made on a bed of lies stemming from our own self-delusion. And even if we are a sweet and loving person, we cannot promote deception in any areas of our lives. This deception cannot and will not continue as humanity develops spiritually. We must see and recognize the truth and get beyond the ego self and its environmental deceptions. Ultimately, there is no other purpose for our lives but spiritual growth and soul evolution, a process to reclaim ourselves back into self-love and self-sovereignty. And this misaligned thought form is that we think from our ego perception that we are in control of our lives and know what is best. This thought form invites great personal suffering. And most of us stay in the pitfall of immense pain from desperately wanting something different to happen to us. And this thought form also invites great personal suffering. The primary crisis in our world, however, is not the cultural, political, or religious framework used to enforce spiritual oppression. The crisis we are facing is in ourselves, humanity, and the planet. It's a crisis of consciousness. The lack of self-awareness combined with the utter lack of consciousness results in an inability to directly experience our true essential nature as spiritual beings. As long as we cannot recognize the true essential divine nature existing inside ourselves, then we are unable to recognize the same essential nature inside everyone that is inherent in all things. At this time, the essence of forced intention, which has animated into earthly matter and its many external creations, will begin to reveal its true nature fully to the observer. That true nature is its source field, and this will be made known to those with a deep feeling heart. And those who live by the guided intelligence of the heart brain are the ones to see rightly what was previously made invisible. The true nature of any entity, creation or manifestation, can be felt and seen through the developed heart consciousness, which may be discerned in its quality through an energetic signature. And when we have developed energetic discernment, we can differentiate the quality of dead energy, anti-life, and living light energy behind the words, thoughts, images, and manifestations. The three main spiritual forces that are contained within the world collective soul in earthly matter are the collective consciousness, which is connected to either the forces of Christos, living light, Luciferianism, false light, or Satanism, material force or elemental matter. In certain areas where we're asked for spiritual growth beyond anything else, we may have periods where we are undergoing deep testing to our personal truth and personal beliefs. Eventually, we are all able to be in this world, yet not of it, and have fulfilling, loving, and appreciative bonds shared with others, whether in groups or personal relationships. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video.